Hi guys, and welcome to Pro Speed Baseball. And today we're going to talk about how to create massive amounts of speed with the correct pitching mechanics. And we're going to talk about really the only thing that matters when creating a ton of speed. If you want to throw at 90 miles an hour, you want to throw at 100 miles an hour, you want to throw at 105 miles an hour like Aroldis Chapman, this is the only piece that matters to maximizing speed. Everything else you do is to maximize the kinematic sequence, and that's the transfer of energy. We're going to talk about how you can do this properly, some things that you're going to be looking for, and we're going to take a look at Aroldis Chapman, who is the best that I have seen just about of all time, definitely the best I've seen lately, at maximizing the kinematic sequence and getting the most speed that you can get so you can start cracking those barriers of 90, 95, 100 miles an hour and the correct biomechanics to do that. So let's go ahead and get started. Okay, so when we're talking about the kinematic sequence, really the best representation of this is talking about a bullwhip, and I know it's used a lot. The reason it's used so much is because it's really just a great demonstration of how you can create speed with a transfer of energy. And if we take a look at this person cracking this whip, the first thing you'll notice is as the hand moves forward, it's going to accelerate first. So the hands move from here all the way up here, so it's probably moved a couple of feet. And as this is happening, he's now starting to decelerate his hand a little bit. And you can see that the energy is going from the handle of the whip up through the midsection of the whip here. Now, as he continues forward, the hand really isn't going to move much anymore. The hand is going to decelerate, and the energy keeps on transferring. Let's go ahead and go a little farther here. And now you can see that the energy from the middle of the whip has gone through an acceleration phase, and then it starts to decelerate. And then all that's left is the tip of the whip. Now, as the tip of the whip cracks, the whip is actually moving over 400 miles an hour, and the crack that you hear is actually a sonic boom. It's breaking the speed of sound. It's creating a shock wave, and you're hearing that crack. The exact same thing happens when we're talking about getting speed and pitching. We accelerate the hips first, just like he did with the hand here. Let's go through this again. So we accelerate, let's imagine these are the hips. Those are gonna accelerate first, then they start to decelerate. The second piece of the whip here would be the shoulders. It accelerates, and then it begins, so it's accelerating up to here, and then it begins to decelerate. And then the final piece is gonna be the arm, which is the tip. It accelerates last, and if we get that sequence right and we conserve the energy the best we can, we're gonna pitch with tons of speed. So let's go ahead and get started and talk about how to do this. All right, so now we've seen how the kinematic sequence, how speed, it all comes from a transfer of energy. Energy has to come from somewhere and be transferred to somewhere else. And we wanna have this act as a multiplier. We wanna to maximize every bit of energy that we can get to create tons of speed. And as I mentioned, Aroldis is the best that I've ever watched in slow motion as far as maximizing this kinematic sequence. We're going to take a look at a couple things here. We're going to go to the top of his loading position here. Top of his leg lift. And I'm going to draw a line from the front side of the rubber. So basically on the back side of his foot here. And I really want to pay attention to what the hips are going to do. And we're going to relate this directly to what we just watched the bullwhip do to create massive amounts of speed. He's going to do the exact same thing with his body, just with a slightly different mechanics. So as he starts to stride forward, this is probably one of the most important keys to being able to generate a lot of speed. Now you'll notice that he has, let's go ahead and mark a couple things here. Let's mark his center gravity. For males, your center gravity is 2 inches below your waist, roughly, just generally speaking. Females is a little bit lower. So his center of gravity is high here. And as he starts forward, look how his center of gravity is gonna start to transfer forward. And now his center of gravity, again, it's in the middle of his body, about 2 inches below the belt. That's where his center of gravity is. So if we take this back line, he's already moved his center of gravity forward about a foot or a foot and a half, and look how closed his hips are. So what he's doing here is he's conserving energy. He's not burning any energy at this point. For those of you who are struggling with speed, you're probably already spinning out a little bit at this point. For those of you who have a lot of speed, you're probably already fairly closed at this point, just like we're seeing with Aroldis. We look at his shoulders, they're facing away from the catcher. The catcher would be able to see the middle of his back here. And if we're looking at his, it would be his right pocket, your left pocket for your right-handed pitchers. That's going to be facing the catcher at this point. So really pay attention to that when you're watching video of yourself pitching, and you'll see that at this point, as he started to transfer forward, this hip is still facing toward the catcher, and that's conserving energy. He's not going to burn any of that energy. We only have so much to use. We want to save it up for later on. And he's going to continue to keep this closed as he goes farther and farther forward. So I want to go ahead and zoom on all the way until his hips are basically perpendicular to home plate. And the camera has moved here a little bit, so let's go ahead and make another line. Now at this point, he's transferred. This was his center of mass, center of gravity when we started out. That was about right here at this point. Look how much his center of gravity has lowered and shifted forward. He's about 4 feet from this back line. And look how his hips are still perpendicular to home plate. Now what this means is that he's still saving up this energy. A lot of pitchers, if you watch, almost all pitchers are going to be more open than this. They're burning and wasting energy as they're coming through here, but not Aroldis. He's saving it up. Now from this point, this is when the energy starts to transfer. So from about right here, all the way until the lead leg hits the ground, this is when the hips are going to start to fire, and we're going to talk about the kinematic chain. So the hips go first, then the shoulders, and then the arm. Just like we saw with the whip, it starts with the handle and it transfers energy through there. Once the hips have gone and this lead leg hits the ground, this is when we're going to start the deceleration. So the front leg is just slamming into the ground. This is what's called hitting the wall. So at this point, he's going to put tons of pressure into this lead leg, and he's going to first decelerate the hips. Now notice at this point, the shoulders are still back. So even though he's used the hips, he's rotated the hips, they're going to be facing home plate, facing the catcher at this point. He hasn't burned the energy from his shoulders. He's still storing that up. Now as he transfers that even more through that chain, now we're going to see next the shoulders are going to go. Now the shoulders are also facing toward home plate. You'll notice here if we look at the hips again, they're still facing their home plate. They've actually decelerated. They're not rotating anymore. They've slammed into that wall. They've braced up by driving into this lead leg, and now they're starting to decelerate. Now the shoulders are starting to decelerate, and the only thing left at this point is the arm. That's the only part that hasn't gone through there. And just like that bullwhip, when it cracked at the end, we're saving all that energy for the last little piece here. And now we can see the hips have fired and decelerated, the shoulders have fired and decelerated, and the last thing to go is going to be this lead arm. And as he comes all the way on through, now the chest or the shoulders, they're basically facing toward home plate. They've rotated a little bit more coming through there. The hips are toward home plate, the arm is toward home plate, and the head is toward home plate. Now everything is released, fully released, the whip is cracked, and you've maximized that kinematic sequence. So let's go ahead and recap on a couple of the key points. This is a very general overview. Let's focus on a couple of key points that you can take to your pitching to start throwing faster and harder, just like we're seeing here with Aroldis. So piece number one, as you're starting your forward momentum, you want to get your weight well forward of the rubber. So this vertical line here is basically the front side of the rubber. You want to get your weight well forward of the rubber and still have your lead hip facing the catcher. He should be looking at your pant pocket at this point. You want to go even farther than this, getting great separation. Shoulders are still back. Now the hips are basically going to be perpendicular to home plate at this point. And we're looking at getting about a 4 foot stride from this lead side of the rubber. So if you're watching yourself on video, the first checkpoint is making sure that your lead hip pocket is facing the catcher as you start your forward momentum. The second checkpoint is going to be as your hips get perpendicular to the catcher, we're looking for about a 4 foot clearance from the back side of the rubber or the front side of the rubber. Now that's going to take a little bit of work to do. If you're not really tall, you may get a little bit less in here. But the key is that we're really transferring our energy forward and we're not burning it, we're not losing it, we're saving it up to use. Now the third piece that I really want you to focus on is as this lead leg hits the ground, now you're going to feel all of your energy transferring down into the ground here. I mean, I don't know how much Aroldis weighs, I'm guessing about 200 pounds. If there was a weight scale under his lead leg here, it would be registering at 500 or 600 pounds right now because he has all his momentum and all his force going down into the ground. And what that's going to do is that's going to decelerate his hips, that's going to decelerate his shoulders, and it's going to let his arm whip through just like we saw with the bull whip. So to recap on those 3 points, as you start your momentum forward, hip pocket toward the catcher, as your hips are perpendicular to the catcher, I want you to have plenty of clearance from the front side of this rubber. We're looking at about 4 foot here. And then finally, the third piece, as you're getting this lead leg into the ground, you're gonna put tons of pressure in that lead leg. You're gonna feel like you're driving down into the ground. You feel like if you had something underneath that lead foot, you would just crush it with all the pressure that you have here. And we can actually see as he's coming through, watch the lead leg as he finishes up. Watch it actually straighten up from that pressure. That's exactly what he's doing. That's called hitting the wall. That's deceleration. That's going to let your arm accelerate and going to transfer all the energy into your arm instead of wasting energy. All right, so I hope you guys really enjoyed this video and enjoyed talking about the physics and the biomechanics, how the body moves to create tons of speed, watching one of the game's greatest all time demonstrate this for us. Now, if you want to improve your speed, there's a great video series that Michael's done. It's about a 4 or 5 part series talking about the proper pitching mechanics, how you can increase your speed, consistency, and really your overall rhythm and technique as you're doing that. I'm going to play a preview from one of those videos, and if you want to watch the entire series, just click the link in the bottom right hand side of your screen or down below in the description. You'll be able to watch that entire video plus the entire series free of charge. Never going to cost you a dime. It's going to help you to pitch harder, pitch faster, and pitch more accurate. Good luck to you guys, and we'll see you soon.
And do you feel a little weak when you're starting to throw the ball? You feel like your upper body's doing a lot of the work? Well, today I'm going to show you how to properly utilize the stride to get your lower half into it and maximize speed in the pitching mechanics. Let's go ahead and get started. Okay, guys, so today we're going to talk about how to get the correct overall stride shape. Correct overall stride shape, simply put, is going to be our foot going down below our body, then glide across the clay to the plate. Okay, what goes wrong a lot of times with a lot of younger pitchers is they'll get up into this loading position and they'll kick their foot out real fast and in order to, they're trying to rush to get to the plate. Now, we don't want to do this for a couple of reasons. First of all, when our foot kicks out, we're going to start leaning back to counterbalance, and we're actually going to create a reverse spine angle. We're going to have to overcompensate, and we get a lot of high throws, a lot of low throws.